You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host, and today I have a familiar face, at least to the Ash Street section of the city of Brockton. Rigoberto?
How you doing, Mark?
Is it Rigoberto or are you Tito? Is Tito to your friends and Rigoberto's your formal name?
Rigoberto's my real name. Tito's my what they call me for short, for Rigoberto.
Okay, that's a little easier. I might do the Tito.
That's fine.
I like that.
That's great.
I grew up on Ash Street, 200 Ash Street. That's where I lived till I went to college. Nice neighborhood. When I was there, the park was brand new. It was just redone. 1975, they redid the whole park. They put in beautiful tennis courts, all of that. Your group is a community group that has reclaimed it over the course of time, keep it neat and clean, and do activities for people there. You've taken it to the library, okay? On August 26th, you're going to do a community back-to-school backpack giveaway. Let's talk about it.
So I would usually do it at the park, but they usually told me that I couldn't pull out a permit because they gave me to do the construction over there at the park.
Right. Which is good news.
Which is good news for us, which we're looking for. We're excited about that. We're going to be doing it at the library because I think it's a safer place for the kids. Mm-hmm. And the parents feel safer to bring the kids into the library. And the kids are always there. So what better place to do it than the library?
Well, you know? You got a good partner over there, Melise Vega, correct, who helps everybody over there. We have a warm, welcoming atmosphere over there. And the reason I say we is I'm on the Board of Trustees. Okay, but the library is a wonderful place. It's where everybody in the whole community goes. And we're all about kids, right? Ash Street is all about kids. Library is all about kids. So it's a good partnership. And your group has kind of made the library a home away from home.
Yes.
Right? You're going to do Christmas giveaway there. I know some of your events are there. We have a lot of people that come to the library because we want people to think of the library as a community center.
Correct.
For everybody. You're a taxpayer. I'm a taxpayer. We pay for the library, and it's the people's university, right? From all the little people,
correct,
all the way up to the senior citizens, which I'm heading toward. So what you're going to do is you're going to give away free school supplies, and school supplies cost money nowadays.
Yes.
They're not cheap.
Yes, and we're fortunate to get some funding, you know, some funding for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we got some money that was sent to us, and Walmart actually donated some money to us to be able to get some supplies.
Okay.
And to buy some backpacks for the kids this year. And
backpacks are expensive.
They're expensive, so we're fortunate enough to get some money from them to help us to get through this event.
So you got backpacks. In the backpacks of school supplies, you got one.
I got one with me.
Don't go too far because you got a mic on, but that's the backpack.
And inside the backpack, they have notebook. They have notebook. They have a folder, notebook. They got a pouch supplies. Inside the pouch, they have pencils, erasers, sharpeners, and a ruler. Everything a child needs for a class to start a class the first day of school.
You can't go wrong with that because the parents aren't just buying school supplies. They're buying clothes. They're buying food.
Yeah.
And after a while, there's only so much in the well to get the money. So at the event, you get games and Toy Story characters. Any preview of who those Toy Story characters might be?
It's got to be a special guest. I can't give you
that. Okay, you can't reveal that at this time.
You've
got to be surprised.
Yeah, it's going to be very nice.
Okay.
Very interesting. Yes.
Okay. We don't promote raffles, but there's going to be a raffle there. Balloons. Kids love balloons, right?
Balloons, yes.
Balloons are good. Face painting?
Face painting, correct.
You know, one of my friends joked to me, you have a face for radio, so you get your face painted. But kids love face painting.
Yes, they do.
The Harvest Fest they do in the park, any event. You can, and you know, there are kids like at the Y and stuff that do, who's doing the painting? Is your wife doing the painting?
Paul's daughter for the director of the library.
Oh, his Paul's daughter. Okay, cool.
Paul's daughter's going to do it.
See, it's all in the family. Yeah. You have a DJ.
Yes, we're going to have music for the kids also, yes.
DJ Darren?
Darren, yes.
Okay. And food?
Food, yes. Light refreshment for the kids. It's going to be some food for the kids also so they can snack on.
So we're looking, it's a Monday night, August 26th, right before school starts. School starts, I think, the 4th?
Correct.
4 to 8, because the library, main library downtown is open on Monday nights, 4 to 8. Branches aren't open that night. Main is open. And 4 hours, that's a long time. You know, parents that there's a parent home can come before the end of the workday, and then the parents that work till 5 still have time to come.
Bring the kids over.
Okay. I see you're partnering up with not just the Ash Street Park Neighborhood Association, the library, but Fire Winds of Hope. That's a new organization.
New organization. They're a faith-based program.
Yeah.
They're a Christian program.
Okay.
They're faith-based, and we're partnering up with them also.
Good.
So they'll be working with us a lot now.
Do you need help, volunteers? I know you probably have volunteers with the Ash Street Park Neighborhood Association. Do you need any help that day?
Yes, we could still use some help.
Okay.
Volunteering, setting up, and helping out, give out the supplies to the kids.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we do.
So if they want to call somebody, would they call Melise?
Yes, they can call Melise.
So Melise's number at the main library number is 508-580-7890, extension 205. You can email her too at mvega, V-E-I-G-A, at COBMA.US, which stands for City of Brockton, Mass. US. And make sure you check out the brand new City of Brockton website that just got launched on August 15th. So anything I missed or anything else you want to talk about?
I just want to just touch on something. We have a pumpkin fest carving competition that's coming on October 29th. And I just...
Not too early to talk about pumpkins.
It's not too early, but it's going to be very nice. So this will be for our next show. So look, stay tuned for that.
And that's at the library, too.
That's also at the library.
Okay, pumpkins. I just started seeing pumpkin spice coffee. And, yes. You know, we're not into fall yet. We're still in summer, but... Yes. I don't know, my wife likes pumpkin spice coffee, so I like other kind of pumpkin stuff. Pumpkin pie would be good
for
me.
Pumpkin pie is good, yeah.
But I think you're doing a great thing, good work, nice to see. There's a few different backpack giveaways going on, but right at the library where everybody knows how to get there, you know, it helps out in this day and age when things cost so much. So good work. You'll be back. I'll bring you back. We'll talk about Pumpkin Fest when we get into September, before October. And then I know you'll be doing Christmas stuff, and you just guys, you know, volunteer spirit. So thanks for everything that you do.
Thank you, Mr. Mark. Thank you for having me on
the show. You're welcome. So just to recap real quick, Brockton Public Library event with the Ash Street Park Neighborhood Association and Fire Winds of Hope. It's a community back-to-school backpack giveaway with free school supplies, games, toys, raffles, balloons, DJ, food. Monday, August 26, 2019, from 4 to 8 at the main library, which is 304 Main Street. Thanks for joining us on Greater Brockton, and we will be back with more segments.